In Afghanistan today, U.S. aircraft staged some of their most intensive bombing attacks of the campaign, concentrating especially around the Taliban stronghold of Kandahar. As CBS News national security correspondent David Martin reports, anti-Taliban Afghan forces on the ground are now benefiting from some U.S. air power.
Rebel fighters who for years have been locked in a stalemate with the Taliban military are now being directly aided by the U.S. military. For the first time today, F-15 Eagles, the Air Force's premier ground attack aircraft, flew all the way from Kuwait to strike the Taliban front lines in northern Afghanistan. This is where the most important battle is being waged, the crossroads town of Mazar-e-Sharif. This video shows U.S. planes striking a Taliban tank at the airport just outside the town. And today, the rebels appear very close to taking that airport.
The reports I have seen is that they are at the airport. I've not seen a report that says they have taken and control the airport.
The rebels are already being assisted by the CIA, but the rugged landscape of Afghanistan has crippled their supply lines and limited their advances. If they seize the airport at Mazar-e-Sharif, the U.S. can fly in supplies directly, probably from a nearby base in Uzbekistan, where 1,000 American combat troops are already positioned. That's what makes Mazar-e-Sharif so important.
It's a large airport. It would provide a number of allies or coalition forces, if control of that area was available to the U.S. or others, to be able to move closer into the country.
U.S. aircraft continue to strike targets throughout Afghanistan, although the Pentagon admits it struck these two Red Cross warehouses by mistake, thinking they contained military equipment. What the U.S. didn't destroy by accident, the Taliban is taking on purpose.
Last night, the Taliban military seized control of two of our large warehouses in Kandahar and Kabul, seizing almost 7,000 metric tons of food.
Dan, the U.S. is now openly warning the Taliban American commandos will be coming to get them. In a propaganda broadcast beamed into Afghanistan, the U.S. says in part, our helicopters will rain fire down upon your camps. Our infantry is trained for any climate and terrain on Earth. Surrender now, and we will let you live. Dan?
Live at the Pentagon, David Martin.